Hey YouTube, welcome back to another video. Today is a true story about how I got started in photography as a big flop. I remember the story very well. I had just bought an Olympus E300. Now that takes me back a few years. And I had a little Mac at home, and the only software I really knew was Photoshop Elements, and I didn't know much in that program to begin with. But you know, I was enjoying taking pictures, and one of my relatives had this really good idea that I should shoot the family portrait when we all get together. And there's about 25 of us or so for the family portrait. So, you know, being young and not too smart, I said, sure. So we go out to meet for this portrait at this beautiful park, this arboretum in Asheville. And I had done a little reading on the online or in bookstores. It didn't have a lot of internet material as we do today. I would have done better. So I went out to the arboretum and I found these steps under a tree where I could stagger the people. Well, that was good. That was a good start. And there was just a little problem, and it was about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and there were some, you know, warmer spots in the group, you know, just a little brighter than it probably should be. But me being an x-ray technologist at the time working in the hospital, you know, I like things a little bit hotter. So, you know, I figured I can fix that in post. So the bad thing about it on top of this was they wanted me in the picture, so I had to set my camera up on a tripod, and then, you know, everybody had to wait and for it to click and smile. And, you know, and I had a lot of advice coming at me, you know, what's your depth of field, blah, blah, blah. Luckily, you know, I did shoot at F16, so I had plenty depth of field. And got done with the pictures, you know, everybody's excited. And I took the pictures home and I developed them. And, you know, they weren't real happy with the picture.
You have no idea.
You know, the hot spots, I didn't shoot in RAW. I didn't know how to recover highlights. You know, just a few people were fried, but you know, it wasn't a professional picture to say the least. So, my family kind of hung me on a tree for this one. Yep, you know, they let me know their displeasure. So right now I'm going to show you an example of my family picture. I wish I had that picture that I could share with you, but I'm going to show you what I did to fix the problem for the family. You know, you've got to be proactive, and when someone is not happy, you need to find a way to make them happy and fix the problem. So here's a picture of my family. Now, this is a pretty decent picture. My sister-in-law snapped, but out of this picture, I can show you what I did to fix the family picture to make them happy. So right now, I'm going to show you the fixed picture. Here we go. Yep, I did it. I sure did. Every single face in the family photo I worked on for a long time. And I made 8x10 copies, and I sent them to the family members as a gift of my artwork. Now, the good news is my dad got this picture. He framed it and laughed at it for over a year. He just laughed and laughed his head off over that picture. Now, there's a lesson in this that I really want you to take to heart. Because at that point in my photography career, and by the way, about the only tool I knew to use in Photoshop Elements, which means I was a fake photographer and not a real photographer because I couldn't afford Photoshop, but was a Liquify tool. It's about the only tool I knew how to play with a little bit, and yet not a whole bunch. But I'm the kind of person that when someone just hammers me or throws it all at me, that I just keep going. I've learned that negativity is fuel to my fire. So when someone tells me I can't do it or I'll never amount to doing it, It really plays into my hand, and it's paid me off over and over. And this was the start, really, a failed start of a career in imaging and video creating. And, you know, I took the lesson, I learned it, I had fun with it, I moved on from it, and now I make a living doing it. So even when you screw up, and I promise you will mess up at some point in your career, I don't even care if you're a seasoned pro, you're gonna mess up somewhere. So even if you mess up, you gotta turn it around and work it in your favor. Don't be so hard on yourself. Laugh a little bit, enjoy the moment just a little bit. If you have no failures, then you never learn anything. Don't live in a safe box. Step outside that box and learn. I want you to know that as you look at my work, as you look at the pictures I post, as you see the videos I post, I started as a complete flop. But now I'm loving what I do. I'm a little better at it than I was before. And, you know, kudos to those people who encourage and uplift. And kudos to those people who even don't. Because the path forward for your success is all up to you. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for more on this channel. I cover business, photo, and film. I believe all of them go together really well. So we don't want to leave anything out. So you can be a successful artist all the way through. I have links down below of all my gear. They're affiliate links. Feel free to click on them. Check out my winner or loser series. Fantastic series. And hey, we will see you in the next video. And don't forget to subscribe.